The US Secretary of State has told Pakistan it must do more to target militants hiding on its territory. Hillary Clinton made a surprise visit to the country amid a breakdown in trust between Washington and Islamabad in the wake of the killing of Osama bin Laden. Well, let's talk about this with Lawrence Davidson. He's a professor of Middle East history at Westchester University in Pennsylvania. Dr. Davidson, thanks very much indeed for joining us. Well, relations between Pakistan and the US are strained at the best of times. Of course, as I've just mentioned, not helped by the anger generated from by the recent killing of bin Laden. So do you think the surprise visit from Clinton will actually smooth things over? As she says, it could be a turning point in relations. Do you think that's optimistic?
Well, it's probably optimistic, yes. The problem is that the U.S. has relations with the Pakistani government and with the Pakistani military. It doesn't have very good relations with the Pakistani people. And one of the problems that the Pakistani government confronts is that most of its population, or at least probably more than 50% of its population, and probably a high percentage of the folks in the security services are sympathetic to the Taliban and to the, not only in Pakistan, but also the Taliban in Afghanistan. And so under those circumstances, there's only so much the Pakistani government can do.
Good afternoon.
And if Clinton and the Obama administration wants them to do more than that, it's not in their own interest to do that. That's why you're getting this sort of yes, no kind of scenario where the Pakistanis say, okay, we're an ally of yours, but only do so much.
But isn't it in the interest of the Pakistani authorities to make that opinion within Pakistan more compatible and cooperative towards America? After all, America has invested a huge amount, something like $20 billion on aid to Pakistan since 2002. And of course, the Pakistani people have been benefiting from that. But when you bear in mind that bin Laden was able to live untouched just 100 kilometers away from the country's capital, you'd think the US would want something more in return. In fact, questioning what actually is it getting in return for its money?
Right. Well, you know, most of that aid, going back to your assertion that the Pakistani people benefit from it, most of the aid is military aid, and a high percentage of that military aid is spent in the United States. What we're getting back, I assume, is a holding action.
But sorry to interrupt, but what is it crucial here is that the U.S. want help from Pakistan over Afghanistan, isn't it? That's the crucial thing.
Yes. And they want the border secured. Yeah. They want the border secured, except that the Pakistani government and the Pakistani military are not able to do that. It would cause civil war in their country to do that. So if you really go after what the Americans want you to go after, it would, the domestic repercussions would be potentially devastating.
Well, you're talking about the insurgency. You're talking about those insurgency operations operating from within what some people say is a safe haven in Pakistan. Are you saying that there's no way that even the Pakistani authorities can concentrate their efforts on that?
Oh, sure, they could, but they're not willing to because of the domestic repercussions. I mean, you've got incipient civil war now. Military forces attacked can't even build a road, actually, without in that area without getting an attack. So how far do you want to push this? The Pakistanis are not willing to push it as far as the Americans want to push it. Actually, the Pakistanis feel that their real problem is on the Indian border and not on the Afghan border. So, you know, they want the aid. They don't want the repercussions of doing what the Americans want them to do, and they try to walk a middle line.
Well, you paint a very bleak picture, a picture of stalemate in effect. Now, being a historian, often, of course, you're always looking into the past, but, of course, part of your job is to look into the future. So where is all this going to be resolved? How is it going to be resolved then?
Actually, you know, historians aren't very good at what-if questions. So I'm not sure how this is going to be resolved. Let's put it this way. It's going to be resolved by the Americans getting out of Afghanistan. That's how it's going to be resolved.
And how will Afghanistan fare from that once the Americans leave? Just very briefly, the future for Afghanistan once the Americans leave. Just briefly.
The Taliban will come back.
All right, we'll leave it there. Very interesting. I'd love to talk to you more on this, but sadly we are out of time. Dr. Lawrence Davidson, thank you for joining us. Professor of Middle East History at Westchester University in Pennsylvania. Thanks.
My pleasure.